Now, he doesn't know I'm coming, so I'm going to try to sneak up on him.
Not exactly the best day to be looking at Corvettes.
What's going on, y'all? My name's Charlie, and welcome to Go Fast Nation. Once again, being a trucker's paying off. I get to go hang out with Rick Corvette Conti.
Yeah.
He's a national Corvette salesman at Coughlin Chevrolet in Pataskala, Ohio. Now, he doesn't know I'm coming, so I'm going to try to sneak up on him. I just hope he's there. Anyway, let's go check it out.
He's bound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we going to do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound just like a bandit run. Keep your foot hard on the pedal, son, never mind them brakes. Let it all hang out, cause we got a run to make.
Yeah, I'm Bobtail. That's why I was able to show up. I have come here with a trailer before, but it's gotten significantly tighter. Anyway, let's see if we can't find him.
I found him. He's here. Check it out. Hey.
What, you mean you're actually not, you know, busy? Not
just... been, a lot of the stuff I do is right here online with you guys, so I don't really have a lot of people here in the office, and I'm working behind the scenes, working another video. You're working on another video. Well, this video's already done. If you're seeing it, it's already done. It's not being worked on.
Right.
Hey, good to see you, dude. What's going on?
Yeah, for those of you who don't know, this is Rick Corvette Conti, the best Corvette salesman in the nation, as far as I'm concerned.
That's crazy. And I think I deserve a trophy for that. Oh, here's one right here. Fantastic. Whatever.
Yeah, I don't know if you follow him on YouTube. It's Rick Corvette Conti on YouTube.
Yeah.
And if you are, you are very familiar with this place, and I am here to say it is smaller in
usually
person.
Usually when you come in here, bro, I'm right there on that couch sleeping. At this time, you catch me at the end of the day. Usually when you come in, I'm right there on that couch sleeping, and it is so comfy, man. That's the best $500 couch I ever spent. That couch, let me tell you something. This couch right here, guys, this couch. See, how look how good I look on it. See, this is nice.
Absolutely.
No, seriously, this couch is 20 years old, and I paid $500 for it.
Wow.
You said that just a minute ago. You Oh, yeah.
It is very comfortable.
Awesome. No, I'm all about the value story. That's a great value story.
But yes, stop dreaming and start driving. One of these days.
Absolutely.
I will get in one.
With your Go Fast channel and things that you go fast in, eventually a Corvette will come into that scenario. So.
Yes, sir. Well, I know you've got a something against Mustangs, but that's what we focus our channel on at the moment.
Well, you know the story. Did I ever tell you the story about my Uncle Jim?
Your Uncle Jim?
My Uncle Jim in Michigan, when I was a little kid, this is how I came exposed to Corvette. All right, neat story on this. So he used to buy the Mach 1s back in the 70s. Almost every year he'd get a new Mach 1. And I'd be out in the driveway helping him wash the car. I thought it was real cool. Well, he didn't tell me till years later that we're doing Corvette and what have you.
Mm-hmm.
And he says, it's funny to see you doing what you're doing now. And he never told me until I was an adult. And I don't know if I am yet or not. But he said, I'll grow old, I just won't grow up. And he says, you know, it's funny. He goes, Rick, when you were helping me wash the Mustangs, he goes, you would stop washing the Mustang because the guy down the street had a Corvette. And when he would cruise by, I would stop and all of a sudden I would turn and watch the Corvette go by. And he goes, you had a natural love affair for that car. And you didn't even know what it was at that time.
So Corvettes are hard not to look at.
Yeah, absolutely.
Especially when they sound good.
I don't even know what the guy had, but it was pretty kick-ass because I actually turned my head. And he got mad and jealous because I wasn't paying attention to his cool Mustang that he just bought. You know, so. It's a good memory. Absolutely.
Well, I was actually hoping, I don't know if it's been sprinkling out there. I was actually hoping we could look at that yellow Z06.
Okay. Want me to get some keys?
Sure.
Absolutely.
I'm sure my viewers would love to check out a C6.
Okay. Give me 1 second. I'll be right back. You go to the key box, and it's a secret code, so you got to stay right there.
I will stay right there. If you're not subscribed to Rick Corvette Conti on YouTube, you need to. Put the information right there. And, go check him out. I'll put a link in the description below. But, I mean, he's a Corvette salesman, he's a YouTuber, excellent YouTube channel, funny as hell, up-to-date Corvette marketplace, tips, tricks, how-tos. It's everything you need to know about a Corvette. You need to find it right here on Rick Corvette Conti on YouTube.
As you can see, we're in the era, shame on me, I'm not wearing a mask right now, but we are in the social distance time frame, depending on when you upload this. You can see my inventory is social distancing.
Yeah.
Means I'm freaking out of cars, man. I usually have 75 to 100 cars, and with the plant not working, we're not getting any new cars, we're not getting any trade-ins, and it is just difficult to sustain right now. So what I have left is just a few cars, but we do have some nice ones. But this is my naked inventory, man. I'm not digging this at all. I'm trying to play it off, but it really does bother me.
Oh, yeah. No, I don't blame you. Can't sell off an empty shelf.
That is correct. I think I've said that a few times.
You have. Z06. Oh yeah. Sounds pretty good for a stock system.
Yeah, it is. Older guy had it out of West Virginia. Didn't really do too much with it. Got a couple of bumps and bruises in the front. I mean, it's not going to be a show queen car in the garage.
Nobody on my channel anyway wants a show clean.
Tear it up!
We're all about going fast and having fun.
No, exactly.
It's got the proper, what do you call it, Mr. Manual?
You know, think about this car and how fast technology has moved. That back in the day when this car come out, man, I remember 06, 07 when I was selling new, you had to wait in line like people are doing now for C8 to get one of these.
Mm-hmm.
It was unbelievable. The demand was huge. It was like 505 horsepower. Wow. It's like, dude, man. It's like, but that's a lot back in the day. And it's a lot now. You got to, I don't care what it is. You got to respect the power. Obviously, the power to weight ratio is a big factor. Torque is a big factor. Torque is huge for Chevy. Sorry. I'm trying to convert them, man. I'm trying to convert them, guys. Come on.
Hey, like I said, we're all about everything fast on this channel. It's not just Mustangs.
Yeah.
Okay, we just happen to own two of them. Okay.
All right. All right. Making sure what we're all about here.
But yes, I know torque. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Mod motors on the Mustangs aren't exactly the most torquey things, but I mean, we're not bad. I can still buck the tires loose.
You know, it's funny. You look at the logo down here in the Z06 emblem, and it says 505. Now, back in the day, when this was released in 06, I had a buddy that was in media and did articles of clothing. He printed a gazillion hats, shirts, jackets when it was first released and not official at 500 horsepower.
Oops.
They did one more SAE test and come out and it was 505. He goes, are you freaking kidding me? He goes, you know how many tens of thousands of dollars of crap I got that I can't... When he goes, what the hell am I going to do with a 500 horsepower one? You know the guys want something that says what my car is and it's 505.
Absolutely.
Unbelievable. A lot of people don't know that story.
7 liters.
Yes, sir.
My gosh.
I did it at K&N. A little extra air filter on it.
Okay.
So that's really, I think, the only thing aftermarket that he's done besides the CD nav.
Yeah, I saw that. Aftermarket there. Radio.
Yeah.
Now, what's funny is that our Mustang doesn't come stock with 500 horsepower, but ours is actually pushing close to 500 horsepower.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
From a 5-liter engine, not great. 7.
So that sucker flies.
It's pretty good. It's pretty good.
Wings that come out on the edge.
It's fast enough to smoke a Viper, I'll tell you that much. The first generation Viper.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, my wife was on the phone with me the other day, and she sends me a picture. She's like, look. I'm like, all right, cool. Yeah, it's the first gen Viper. And she's like, I just smoked his ass. I'm like, nice.
You got a wife that's into this stuff with you too?
Oh yeah.
Cool. Lucky dude behind the camera right now. Guys.
Oh yeah. Yeah, she's she can drive manual just with the best of them. But this thing is gorgeous.
Yeah, this was the featured car when they revealed this in Detroit. I was there. They revealed this and the C6R at the same time at Cobo Hall. So it was pretty neat. And yellow has always been kind of the thing associated with Corvette racing. So this has always been something pretty nostalgic. We just shipped out a twin to this in 2010. Went to Georgia just recently that we shared on our channel.
Yep.
And it was nice to see people interested, you know, in this car. It was the first time that they used aluminum frame.
Yeah.
In Corvette.
Wow.
And that's one of the reasons that the roof didn't come off. You know, so the roof does not come off.
Oh, this isn't a lift roof. I thought all Corvettes were.
Yeah, well, in this generation they weren't. Z06 was the exception, so you couldn't let the roof come off. Now we get into C7, it was.
Gotcha.
A new value story.
Is the block aluminum as well?
Yes.
Okay. So this is all aluminum and fiberglass, basically.
Yeah, your cast iron sleeves, you know, on the inside, but it's just an incredible motor. And you've seen a lot of guys take that crate motor and they put it in so many other things. And,
yep.
Oh my gosh. It's off to the races, baby.
Now back to the color. I actually, when I was eyeballing this earlier before I walked in the door.
Yeah.
I told the channel, I think this is Corvette Racing Yellow. Am I wrong?
This is Velocity Yellow.
Okay, I was wrong.
Yep,
Velocity Yellow.
Yep, that's okay. Very, very similar. And hey, that was a pretty good sound.
It's not bad for a truck. I thought somebody had a hot rod back there.
Sir, we have lots of hillbillies out here.
Out in the sticks of Ohio.
I'm waiting for that, but that's okay. It is what it is, man. We are in Pataskala, is where we're at. You get a lot of that back there, boys. We do. We sell a ton of Silverados here, plus Corvettes.
Nice.
Yeah, but this was Velocity Yellow. But the Corvette Racing Yellow is very, very similar. Probably a shade lighter.
Okay.
And a little bit more of a different on the side of a plus of a green, more of a blue hue type of thing. So very, very different. A little story on the yellow change. It's funny, I was just talking about this earlier with a customer because he's coming down from New York for that Grand Sport on the end down there, which is that's Corvette Racing Yellow.
Okay, so that is Corvette Racing Yellow.
So when they released Corvette Racing Yellow, they did a big reveal at the National Corvette Museum. And usually when you go to those events, when they're going to show new model stuff, they'll show you the new colors and that kind of stuff. So everybody's all ticked off. They say, hey, we're here to see all the new stuff. Had no Corvette Racing Yellow.
Hmm.
So then at one of the seminars, Harlan Charles, who is our Corvette product manager, gets up and says, hey, I know that everybody's upset. They're wanting to see the new Corvette Racing Yellow. He goes, but you guys are familiar with the Corvette race car. And they said, yeah. He goes, do you like the way that car's looked so far this year? Which has been racing for several months. They said, yeah. He goes, well, that's the new yellow. And you didn't even know it. So that's how close it was. They're like, oh, okay. So everyone's thinking there's going to be a big controversy on the yellow chain. So it was that damn close.
Nice.
Yeah, move on with life. Stop worrying about it.
Yeah, I can definitely see the difference between Velocity Yellow.
Yeah. See how it's a little bit lighter even?
Yes. I mean, it's from with the naked eye, it is
which
very
nice
easy.
Is they're equally dirty. So.
Right. Yeah.
Right.
Mother Nature isn't exactly helping out here.
Would you like to know more?
I really do.
So what if any of my viewers are interested in this car, what's the asking price on it?
You know, and I had to double check that because there's a lot bouncing around on this head right here. So easiest way to go to Coughlin Corvette, that's Coughlin Corvette.com. For the used stuff, on the new stuff, go to my site, which is Corvette Conti with an I.com. You can find new specials, up to date, and things like that. So we'll have the very aggressive price posted on there. We do, well, you know, we do 85% of our business out of state. So
yep.
I'd rather put the price what it takes to buy it rather than do the old school games. I appreciate the promotion.
You know, oh, yeah, definitely.
Go back and forth and all that kind of stuff. Hey, if you're here, you're in Texas, you're in California, and you're online, you see a car you like, you don't have to ask what's it take to buy it. It'd already be posted for you. And I think there's a great value in doing business like that. In addition, you don't call an email and they say, oh no, it's higher. Oh no, you have to do this, which you guys heard that crap before.
Yeah, too. That's the internet price.
Yeah. Yeah, no, not at all. Easy breezy, man. Works for you, works for me too, man. Really does. Absolutely.
Yeah, that thing is gorgeous. How many miles were on it?
37.
37,000 mile car. Gorgeous. I mean, I don't see anything wrong with it. It looks awesome to me.
That's a 2LZ package.
2LZ, okay. Now, what is the difference between the LZs in this generation?
Just some equipment level. You're really going to put me on the spot to remember that. I am old, okay? I'm probably twice your age now, bro.
I really doubt that you're 72 years old.
No, memory package comes into play when you go up to the two package. Power steering column, the heated seats is part of the two package. When you go to the three, then they change the material up on the doors and the dash. So that was going to be some of the changes there.
Okay.
Head-up display comes into play.
Okay.
And you know what? Whether this makes your vlog or not, I can't even remember. Now, because I just don't remember. You're so immersed into the current marketplace. Current Z06 head-up display is standard no matter what level you pick. I don't recall on C6 of it, so shame on me. But
no, hey, yeah. It's an old car.
He's catching me at the end of the day, guys. I've been here for 12 hours. Oh, let me give you a pop quiz. Hey, pop you right in the nose.
Gotcha. Well, Rick, I really appreciate you taking the time out of your busy day to have a chat.
This is fun, man. I love talking Corvettes. I can do this all damn day.
So, again, make sure you subscribe.
Yes, Rick Corvette Conti on YouTube, and the CorvetteConti.com is the website, man. But I'm glad you stopped by. It's always good to see you. Love to see the enthusiasm for go fast cars.
Absolutely. But yeah, I got the truck parked way over there. But all right. Well, thanks again, Rick. Look at this. Oh, I didn't even see that up there. Oh my God. How about that? Is it a blower car? No, it's just a high rim. Oh my God, that thing is wicked. Big block, baby. Oh, wow. I don't know how I missed this. The old drag lights on it. Yeah, baby. What a killer car.
He's pounding down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way.